My name is Alif Nova Aditya. I'm from PBI 4A, and I would like to explain about teaching and learning aids and lesson structure and instructional media. The first topic is teaching and learning aids and lesson structure. When there is a talk about teaching and learning aids in the lesson structure situation, by no means is there an attempt to click for their use in teaching. At this stage of teaching, we have already advanced far enough so that in no longer is necessary to make case for the use of the media. So the next topic, the terms. The first one is audio-visual aids. This is the best and the most term used by the teachers in learning. The second is teaching aids. Founders to use the term teaching aid to summarize instructional and learning aids. Instructional aids are what the teacher uses in presenting a lesson, while learning aids are used by the pupils. The third is media. The use of term media has consequences for the use of term audio-visual aids. And the last is teaching technology. As technical scientific application to teaching with a view to the aim and structure of teaching. The next chapter is integrating media and teaching. The media that we are going to use in a particular lesson will be determined by the use the aim, the teaching strategies, and etc. Thus, media only are able to be integrated into a particular lesson if the lesson is systematically planned according to the three mentioned system or other similar ones. And the next chapter is selecting media. Since the entire problem of media selection is so comprehensive, only a few guidelines from Romisolsky will be discussed. According to Romisolsky, the following factor influence the selection of media for particular reasons, such as the first, learning content; second is type of learning text; the third is teaching strategies; the fourth, student; the fifth, particular limitations; and the last is preferences of the teacher. So the next chapter is instructional media. This learning material is concerned by the media for teaching English. It is important to improve teachers' knowledge about the instructional media in presenting the materials. The biggest problem in teaching English is seeing that learners are not interested in studying. The next is instructional media is for teaching English. Media, it's a kind of components which has information. According to Richard, 1992, in general part, media means for television, radio, and newspapers considered as a world that has ways of entertaining, of reading news or information into large of people. Why we use instructional media? A good media is like a window. It should not be held attention to itself. It should just have been let in the light. Media is very useful in learning the English language. Teachers and learners are helped by using the media to achieve their goals. So the teachers should actively apply the media in teaching learning activities, because there are several benefits, such as the first, instructional media can be solved the lack of the learner's experiences. The second is instructional media can be reach everything out of the class. The third is instructional media are created the possible direct interaction between the learners and their environment. And four, media produce some observation. And the fifth, Media can keep the basic, concrete, and real concepts of teaching. Sixth, the learner's motivation are aroused by using media and learning. And the last, media are integrated the experience from the concrete things to the abstract things. And the next chapter is kinds of media. There are so many instructional media are used in teaching that starting from the simple or the cheapest, such as drawing or teacher model drawings, still picture, audio recording, motion picture and key, real object, simulation and models. This category includes people, events, object, and demonstration. And the last, program and computer-assisted instruction. There are also visual media that can be effectively used by the teachers in classroom. The first one is pictures. In pictures can be a photographs of people, places, or things. The second is realia or real objects. Realia means real things, objects such as coin, tools, plants, animals, or collection of artifacts that teachers bring into the classroom. And the third is drawings or teacher mode drawings. Drawings are simple things to do, but make sure to show a lot of information. And the fourth is chart, poster, and cartoon. And the fifth, blackboard or whiteboard. Sixth, audio media. The seventh is overhead projector, and the last LCD projector. And the last chapter is about selecting the appropriate instructional media in the classroom. Before you begin to teach the classroom by using instructional media, there are several steps you should keep in your mind. The first is review the instructional goals, objectives, audience, and instructional strategies. And second, determine the best medium for your lesson components. And the third is search and review the existing media. And the fourth, if new media or material needs to be developed, you should keep A. Determine format, script, visual, and etc. B. Draft the materials and media. And last, check for clarity and flow of ideas. Fifth, do the evaluation about the instructional media that you want to use. The sixth is apply the instructional media, and the last, evaluate or revise. Okay, I think enough about my explanation, and I think thank you so much for your attention.